The Maratha Empire was the last great Hindu superpower in the Indian subcontinent, preceding the establishment of the modern predominantly Hindu state of India. Before the rise of the Marathas, India had been dominated by the Mughal Empire. The Mughals were Persianized Central Asian Turco-Mongols who had converted to Islam. Claiming descent from Genghis Khan and Tamerlane, they shared their ancestors' acumen for conquest and occasional brutality. Although relatively tolerant of other faiths for the time, the empire became increasingly discriminatory to its majority Hindu population over time. Higher positions in the empire increasingly excluded Hindus, and the jizya infidel tax was imposed. The Marathas were a Hindu warrior class who had mainly worked for the Muslim sultans of the Deccan Plateau. Since the 15th century, the Bhakti movement spread from southern India northwards, increasing the devotion of the Hindu population and the sense of need to create their own strong independent nation. The Maratha nobleman Shivaji, after a lifetime of guerrilla warfare, established an independent kingdom in 1674. He was crowned Chhatrapati, establishing the Maratha Empire. Beginning with 4 forts and 2,000 warriors, he ended his life with over 300 hilltop forts and an army of over 100,000 men. Following his death, the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb dedicated the next 26 years of his life to waging an obsessive and brutal war against the Marathas. Aurangzeb's massive encampment was essentially a mobile capital city, with over 500,000 soldiers and camp followers. By the end of his reign, 3 to 4 million people had perished, primarily resulting from drought, famine, and plague that ravaged the war-torn lands. Although bringing nearly all of India under Mughal influence, the cost was too great for the Mughal Empire to bear. After Aurangzeb's death, the empire was plagued with internal rebellion and strife. Shahuji, the grandson of Shivaji, was released from prison in an attempt to destabilize the Marathas. This led to a civil war that Shahuji would win, and the Mughals were unable to exploit as they were busy dealing with a series of civil wars and rebellions. Shahuji had an eye for talent and promoted based on merit rather than birth or social status, which aided the empire's growth during his long reign. Power was gradually transferred to his generals and the Peshwa, our prime minister. Under Peshwa Bajirao, the Mughals and a coalition of allies were decisively defeated by the Marathas at the Battle of Bhopal, and had sacked the Mughal capital of Delhi a few months before. The Mughals made peace, ceding large swaths of central India to the Marathas and paying massive war reparations, greatly weakening the empire. After Shahuji's death, the Chhatrapati became a ceremonial rule, while real executive power rested with the Peshwa. The Mughal capital of Delhi was sacked and conquered by northern invaders. Then the Marathas conquered Delhi, establishing the Mughal emperor as a puppet ruler, with the only Mughal territory being the city of Delhi itself. As the empire reached its height in power, it had become increasingly decentralized, the Peshwa ceding more and more power to the local Maratha rulers and generals, while his position became more ceremonial, as the Chhatrapatis had become a generation before, leading many historians to give the state the moniker Maratha Confederacy rather than Empire. That same year, the British East India Company established direct rule over Bengal, defeating a coalition of French, Bengals, and Mughals. In 1775, the British East India Company fought to place their favored claimant on the Maratha throne. The Marathas were victorious, and the British made peace. The East India Company set about conquering southern India before resuming war with the Marathas. A peace treaty was signed after making territorial gains, and in a third and final Anglo-Maratha War, the British disestablished the empire in 1818. The legacy of the Maratha is quite exceptional in Indian history. Social mobility and religious tolerance were two of the pillars that gave the nation exceptional internal unity. It did not adhere to the caste system. Merit was prized above all, and people of all castes were found in the highest ranks of the military and civilian positions in the empire. The sons of shepherds and peasants rose to rule large tracts of lands and armies. Since Shivaji founded the empire, religious tolerance was an important societal aspect, and religion was considered a largely personal affair, although the state was undeniably Hindu in character. This has been Epimetheus. Like and subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell icon to get notifications every time I make a new video. Thanks for watching.